I lends us sinners, O God, cleanse us sinners, and have mercy upon us. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Beside them, the birds of the air have their habitation, their voices resound amid the rocks. He waters the mountains from his upper chambers, the earth is filled with the fruit of your work. He causes the grass to grow for the cattle and herbs for the service of man, that he may bring forth food from the earth and wine that makes glad the heart of man, oil to make his face shine and bread to strengthen man's heart. The trees of the field are full of sap, even the cedars of Lebanon which he has planted. There the birds make their nest, the abode of the stork is foremost among them. The high hills are a refuge for the wild goats, the rocks are a refuge for the hyrax. He appointed the moon for the seasons, and the sun knows its time for setting. You make darkness, and it is night, wherein all the beasts of the forest do move. The young lions roar after their prey, seeking their food from God. When the sun arises, they gather together and lie down in their dens. Man goes forth to his work and to his labor until the evening. O Lord, how magnified are your works, in wisdom you have made them all. The earth is filled with your creation. Behold the sea, great and wide, in which are teeming things innumerable, living things both small and great. There go the ships of that Leviathan, which you fashioned to play therein. These all look to you, that you may give them their food in due season. When you give it to them, they gather it. When you open your hand, they are filled with good things. When you hide your face, they are troubled. When you take away their breath, they die and return to their dust. When you send forth your spirit, they are created and you renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. He looks on the earth and it trembles. He touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praises to my God while I have my being. May my words be pleasing to him. I will be glad in the Lord. May sinners be consumed out of the earth and the wicked be no more. Bless the Lord, O my soul. The sun knows it's time for setting, you make darkness and it is night. O Lord, how magnified are your works, in wisdom you have made them all. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God.
Blessed is the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
What loiters on the way that sinners take, what sits about with scoffers, but finds his pleasure in the law of the Lord and murmurs his law day and night. He is like a tree that is planted by water streams, yielding his fruit in season, his leaf never fading. Success attends all he does. It is nothing like this with the wicked, nothing like this. No, these are like chaff blown away by the wind. The wicked will not stand firm when judgment comes, nor sinners when the virtuous assemble. The Lord guards the way of the just, but the way of the wicked leads to doom. Alleluia.
For the Lord guards the way of the just, but the way of the wicked leads to doom.
Why this impotent muttering? Kings on earth rising in revolt, princes plotting against the Lord and his anointed. Now let us break their fetters, now let us throw off their yoke. The one whose throne is in heaven sits laughing, the Lord derides them, and angrily he addresses them, in a rage he strikes them with panic. This is my King, installed by me on Zion, my holy mountain. Let me proclaim the Lord's decree. He had told me, you are my son. Today I become your father. Ask and I will give you the nations for your heritage, the ends of the earth for your domain. With iron scepter you will break them, shatter them like potter's ware. So now you kings learn wisdom, earthly rulers be warned. Serve the Lord with fear and trembling. Pay him your homage. Alleluia.
Serve the Lord with fear and trembling. Pay him your homage.
He will be angry and you will perish, for his anger is very quick to blaze. Blessed are they who put their trust in God. Alleluia.
Blessed are they who put their trust in God. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
O Lord, more and more are turning against me, more and more rebelling against me, more and more saying about me, there is no help for him and his God. But, O Lord, my encircling shield, my glory, you help me hold up my head. Loudly I cry to the Lord, and he answers me from his holy mountain. Now I can lie down and go to sleep and then awake, for the Lord had hold of me. No fear now of those tens of thousands posted against me wherever I turn. Arise, O Lord, save me, my God. Alleluia.
Arise, O Lord, save me, my God. Alleluia.
All my enemies to the cheekbone, you break the teeth of the wicked. O Lord of salvation, bless your people. Alleluia.
O Lord of salvation, bless your people. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen.
How long will you love vain words and seek after lies? But know that the Lord has set apart the godly for himself. The Lord hears when I call to him. Be angry, but sin not. Commune with your own hearts on your beds and be silent. Offer right sacrifices and put your trust in the Lord. There are many who say, oh, that we might see some good. Lift up the light of thy countenance upon us, O Lord. Thou hast put more joy in my heart than they have when their grain and wine abound. In peace I will both lie down and sleep. For thou alone, O Lord, makest me dwell in safety. Give ear to my words, O Lord, give heed to my groaning. Hearken to the sound of my cry, my King and my God, for to thee do I pray. O Lord, in the morning thou dost hear my voice, in the morning I prepare a sacrifice for thee and watch. For thou art not a God who delights in wickedness, evil may not sojourn with thee. The boastful may not stand before thy eyes, thou hatest all evildoers. Thou destroyest those who speak lies, the Lord abhors bloodthirsty and deceitful men. But I, to the abundance of thy steadfast love, will enter thy house. I will worship toward thy holy temple in the fear of thee. Lead me, O Lord, in thy righteousness, because my enemies make thy way straight before me. For there is no truth in their mouth, their heart is destruction, their throat is an open sepulchre. They flatter with their tongue. Make them bear their guilt, O God, let them fall by their own counsels. Because of their many transgressions, cast them out, for they have rebelled against thee. But let all who take refuge in thee rejoice, let them ever sing for joy, and do thou defend them. That thou, those who love thy name may exult in thee. For thou dost bless the righteous, O Lord, thou dost cover him with favor as with a shield. O Lord, rebuke me not in thy anger, nor chasten me in thy wrath. Be gracious to me, O Lord, for I am languishing. O Lord, heal me, for my bones are troubled, my soul also is sorely troubled. But thou, O Lord, how long? Turn, O Lord, save my life, deliver me for the sake of thy steadfast love. For in death there is no remembrance of thee. In Sheol, who can give thee praise? I am weary with my moaning. Every night I flood my bed with tears. I drench my couch with my weeping. My eye wastes away because of grief. It grows weak because of all my foes. Depart from me, all you workers of evil. The Lord has heard the sound of my weeping. The Lord has heard my supplication. The Lord accept my prayer. All my enemies shall be ashamed and sorely troubled. They shall turn back and be put to shame in a moment. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Now ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, my God, in thee do I take refuge. Save me from all my pursuers, and deliver me. Lest like a lion they rend me, dragging me away with none to rescue. O Lord my God, if I have done this, if there is wrong in my hands, if I have requited my friend with evil or plundered my enemy without cause, let the enemy pursue me and overtake me, and let him trample my life to the ground and lay my soul in the dust. Arise, O Lord, in thy anger, lift thyself up against the fury of my enemies. Awake, O my God, thou hast appointed a judgment. Let the assembly of the peoples be gathered about thee and overtake thy seat on high. The Lord judges the peoples. Judge me, O Lord, according to my righteousness and according to the integrity that is in me. O let the evil of the wicked come to an end, but establish thou the righteous, thou who trieth the minds and hearts, thou righteous God. My shield is with God, who saves the upright in heart. God is a righteous judge and a God who has indignation every day. If a man does not repent, God will whet his sword. He has bent and strung his bow. He has prepared his deadly weapons, making his arrows fiery shafts. Behold, the wicked man conceives evil and is pregnant with mischief and brings forth lies. He makes a pit, digging it out, and falls into the hole which he has made. His mischief returns upon his own head, and on his own pate his violence descends. I will give to the Lord the thanks due to his righteousness, and I will sing praise to the name of the Lord, the Most High. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is thy name in all the earth. Thou whose glory above the heavens is chanted by the mouths of babes and infants. Thou hast founded a bulwark because of thy foes to still the enemy and the avenger. When I look at thy heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars that thou hast established, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou dost care for him? Yet thou hast made him little less than God, and dost crown him with glory and honor. Thou hast given him dominion over the works of thy hands. Thou hast put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, and also the beasts of the field, the birds of the air, the fish of the sea, whatever passes along the paths of the sea. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is thy name in all the earth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory be to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory be to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory be to you, O God.
I looked to the right and watched, but there was nothing in me. I had no refuge nor no prayers for my soul. I cried out to you, O Lord, and said to you, I hope in my portion in the land of the living. Attend to my prayer, for I am not very low. Deliver me from the persecutors, for they are stronger than I. Bring my soul out of prison, that I may pray for you.
Your holy men.
together, let the people be assembled, who among them can declare this, and show us former things, let them bring out their witness, and then they may be justified, or let them hear and say, it is truth. You are my witnesses, says the Lord, and my servant whom I have chosen, that you may know and believe me, and understand that I am he. Before me there was no God formed, nor shall there be any after me. I, even I, am the Lord, and besides me there is no Savior. I have declared and saved, I have proclaimed. There was no foreign God among you, therefore you are my witnesses, says the Lord, that I am God. Indeed, before the day was, I am he, and there is no one who can deliver out of my hand. I work, and who will reverse it? Thus says the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. The reading is from the wisdom of Solomon. But the souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seem to have died, and their departure was thought to be affliction, and their going from us to be their destruction, but they are at peace. For though in the sight of men they were punished, their hope is full of immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great reward, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace, he tried them. Like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. In the time of their visitation, they will shine forth and will run like sparks through the stubble. They will govern nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord will reign over them forever. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his elect, and he watches over his holy ones. The reading is from the wisdom of Solomon. But the righteous live forever, and their reward is with the Lord. The Most High takes care of them. Therefore they will receive a glorious crown and a beautiful diadem from the hand of the Lord, because with his right hand he will cover them, with his arm he will shield them. The Lord will take his zeal as his whole armor, and will arm all creation to repel his enemies. He will put on righteousness as a breastplate, and wear impartial justice as a helmet. He will take holiness as an invincible shield, and sharpen stern wrath for a sword. And creation will join with him to fight against the madmen. Shafts of lightning will fly with true aim, and will leap to the target as from a well-drawn bow of clouds. And hailstones full of wrath will be hurled as from a catapult. The water of the sea will rage against them, and rivers will relentlessly overwhelm them. A mighty wind will rise against them, and like a tempest it will winnow them away. Lawlessness will lay waste the whole earth, and evil doing will overturn the thrones of rulers. Listen therefore, O kings, and understand. Learn, O judges of the earth. Give ear, you that rule over multitudes and boast of many nations, for dominion was given you from the Lord, and your sovereignty from the Most High.
Mercy.
As peacemakers, they became God's children. Persecuted and tortured for righteousness' sake, they now rejoice in heaven. And they pray fervently to the Lord that he may have mercy on our soul.
Now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Let us sound a hymn on the trumpet and praise with one accord the protectress of our land, our queen, the Theotokos. Rejoice, for thou hast crowned our land with thy favor, pouring abundant grace upon it. Therefore, the church in America joyously celebrates thy precious protection, and commemorates the multitude of thy miracles. And now deprive us not of thy mercies, O Lady. Look with favor upon us in our adversities and afflictions, and raise us up by thy powerful intercession. Lord, thou lovest all thy servants, depart in peace according to thy word. For mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all.
Rejoice, O Virgin Theotokos, declare your praise. O Lord, why have they increased to afflict me? Many rise up against me. Many are they who say to my soul, there is no salvation for him and his God. But you, O Lord, are my helper, my glory, and the one who lifts up my head. With my voice I cried to the Lord, and he heard me from his holy mountain. I lay down and slept, I awoke, for the Lord will help me. I will not be afraid of 10,000s of people who have set themselves against me round about. Arise, O Lord, save me, O my God, for you have struck on the cheek all without some cause are my enemies. You have broken the teeth of sinners. Salvation is of the Lord. Your blessing is upon your people. I lay down and slept. I awoke, for the Lord will help me. O Lord, rebuke me not in your wrath, nor chasten me in your anger. For your arrows have pierced me, and you have laid your hand heavily upon me. There is no health in my flesh because of your wrath, nor is there any rest in my bones because of my sins. For my iniquities have gone over my head like a weighty burden. They have pressed heavily upon me. My wounds are foul and festering because of my foolishness. I suffered and was utterly bowed down. All the day long I walked in sadness. For my loins are filled with burning, and there is no soundness in my flesh. I have been afflicted and humbled beyond measure. I cried out because of the affliction of my heart. O Lord, all my desire is before you, and my sighing is not hidden from you. My heart is troubled, my strength fails me, and the light of my eyes is also gone from me. My friends and my neighbors drew near to me and stood silently. My kinsmen stood afar off. Those who sought after my soul used violence. Those who sought my ruin spoke vain things and imagined deceits all the day long. But I, like a deaf man, did not hear, like a dumb man who does not open his lips. I became like a man who does not hear, and in whose mouth are no reproofs. For in you, O Lord, I have hoped. You will hear me, O Lord, my God. I said, let not my enemies rejoice over me, for when my feet slipped, they boasted against me. For I am ready for wounds, and my affliction is continually before me. For I will confess my iniquity, and my soul is afflicted because of my sins. But my enemies live and are mightier than I, and those who hate me wrongfully have multiplied. Those who render me evil for good slander me because I followed after good. Do not forsake me, O Lord, my God. Depart not from me. Attend to my help, O Lord, my salvation. Do not forsake me, O Lord, my God. Depart not from me. Attend to my help, O Lord, my salvation. O God, my God, early in the morning I turn to you, and my soul thirsts for you. How often my flesh longs for you as in a trackless desert land where no water is. So I have appeared before you in the sanctuary to see your power and glory. Because your mercy is better than life, my lips will praise you. Thus I will bless you while I live. I will lift up my hands in your name. My soul will be filled with oil and fat, and my mouth will praise you with joyful lips. I remembered you upon my bed. I meditated on you in the morning. For you have been my helper, and in the shelter of your wings I will rejoice. My soul is cleaved to you, your right hand upholds me. But those who sought my life in vain, they shall be delivered up to the sword. They shall be a portion for foxes. But the king shall rejoice in God, everyone who swears by him shall be praised. But the mouth of those who speak unrighteousness shall be stopped. I meditated on you in the morning, for you have been my helper. And in the shelter of your wings I will rejoice. My soul is cleaved to you, your right hand upholds me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. O Lord God of my salvation, I have cried out day and night before you. Let my prayer come before you. Incline your ear to my supplication. For my soul is full of troubles, and my life draws near to hell. I am counted with those who are down to the pit. I have become like a man without help, free among the dead, like the slain who lie in the grave, who you remember no more, and who are cut off from your hand. You have laid me in the lowest pit, in darkness and in the shadow of death. Your wrath lies heavy upon me. You have afflicted me with all your ways. You put away my acquaintances far from me. They regard me with horror. I was delivered up and have not come forth. My eyes are weakened from weeping. Lord, I have called daily upon you. I have stretched out my hand to you. Will you work wonders for the dead? Will the shades rise up and praise you? Who will tell of your mercy in the grave, or your righteousness in the place of destruction? Will your wonders be known in the darkness, and your truth in the land of forgetfulness? But to you I cry out, O Lord, and in the morning my prayer comes before you. O Lord, why do you cast off my soul? Why do you turn away your face from me? I am poor and in distress from my youth. I was exalted, then I was humiliated and brought very low. Your wrath passed over me, your terrors troubled me. Like water they engulfed me. All the day long they overwhelmed me. You put far away from me my friends, my neighbors, and my acquaintances because of my suffering. O Lord God of my salvation, I've cried out day and night before you. Let my prayer come before you. Incline your ear to my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that's within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgives all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from corruption, who crowns you with mercy and compassion, who satisfies your desire with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord works deeds of mercy and executes justice for all who are oppressed. He made known his ways to Moses, his will to the children of Israel. The Lord is compassionate and merciful, long-suffering and abundant in mercy. He will not always be angry, nor will he be enmity with us forever. He has not dealt with us according to our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. For as the heavens are high above the earth, the Lord has confirmed his mercy on those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed our transgressions from us. As the Father has compassion on his children, so the Lord is compassionate to those who fear him. For he knows whereof we are made, he remembers that we are dust. As for man, his days are like grass. Like the flower of the field, so it blossoms. But when the wind passes over it, it is gone, and its place remembers it no more. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting on those who fear him, and his righteousness to children and children, to those who keep his covenant and remember his commandments to do them. The Lord has prepared his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all his angels, mighty in strength, who do his word, heeding the voice of his word. Bless the Lord, all his hosts, his ministers, who do his will. Bless the Lord, all his works, in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul, in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Hear my prayer, O Lord. Give ear to my supplication in your faithfulness. Hear me in your righteousness. Enter not to judgment with your servant, for in your sight all my living shall be justified. For the enemy has persecuted my soul. He has humbled my life to the ground. He has made me dwell in darkness like those who have long been dead. Therefore my spirit is overwhelmed within me. My heart within me is troubled. I remember the days of old. I meditated on all your works. I mused on the works of your hand. I spread out my hands to you. My soul longed for you like a thirsty lamb. Hear me speedily, O Lord. My spirit failed. Turn not your face from me, lest I be like those who are down into the pit. Make me to hear your mercy in the morning, for in you I have hoped. Make me to know, O Lord, the way in which I should walk, for I have lifted up my soul to you. Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord, for to you I have fled. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Your good spirit shall lead me in the land of righteousness. For your name's sake, O Lord, enliven me in your righteousness. Bring my soul up out of tribulation. In your mercy, cut off my enemies, and destroy all those who afflict my soul, for I am your servant. Hear me in your righteousness, enter not to judgment with your servant. Hear me in your righteousness, enter not to judgment with your servant. Your good spirit shall lead me in the land of righteousness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory be to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory be to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory be to you, O God.
Born is the Lord and has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his love is everlasting.
Born is the Lord and has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord.
All the nations encompassed me, but in the name of the Lord I withstood them.
Born is the Lord.
Life to the
men through the radiance of the angel who appeared to announce the resurrection of the women. We glorify you, the destroyer of corruption. We prostrate before you who have risen from the tomb, who you are only God. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You were willing to be nailed to the cross, O compassionate one, and were placed as dead in the tomb, O giver of life. You destroyed the power of death by your death, O mighty one. For the gatekeepers of Hades trembled before you, and those dead through the ages, you united to yourself, O lover of mankind, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. We all know you to be the mother of God, and we seek refuge in your goodness. For even after giving birth, you showed yourself truly virgin. We sinners have you as our refuge in temptations, you who alone are without stain. Early in the morning, the women came to the tomb, and seeing the angel, were frightened, for the tomb showed forth life, and at this wonder they were afraid. Therefore they went and announced the resurrection to the disciples. Hades is destroyed by Christ, for he alone is powerful and mighty. He awakened all those restrained, removing the fear of punishment by the power of the cross. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You were nailed on the cross, O life of all, and you were numbered among the dead, O Lord. You rose on the third day, O Savior, and awakened Adam from corruption. Therefore, the heavenly powers cry out to you, glory to your suffering, O Christ, glory to your resurrection, glory to your condescension, O only lover of mankind, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. O Mary, worthy dwelling of the Master, lift us who have fallen into the abyss of harsh despair, trespasses, and sorrows, for you are a strong helper and intercession for the salvation of your servants.
Praise the name of the Lord, give thanks, O servants of the Lord, alleluia, you that stand in the house of the Lord.
Thank you.
is risen from the tomb. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
time, when the Sabbath was past, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Salome, brought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, they went to the tomb when the sun had risen. And when there they were saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone from us, for us from the door of the tomb?" And looking up, they saw that the stone was rolled back. It was very large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right, dressed in a white robe. And they were amazed. And he said to them, "Do not be amazed, but seek Jesus of Nazareth, who is crucified. He has risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go tell his disciples and Peter that he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him as he told you." And they went out and fled from the tomb, for trembling and astonishment had come upon them. They said nothing to anyone because they were afraid.
Sing the resurrection of Christ. Let us worship the Holy Lord Jesus, the only one who is without sin. We venerate your cross, O Christ, and praise and glorify your holy resurrection. For you are our God, and we have no other than you. We call on your name. Come, all you faithful. Let us worship the holy resurrection of Christ, for we hold joy for the whole world. Because enduring the cross for us, he destroyed death by death.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy, according to the multitude of your tender mercies, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my wickedness and cleanse me from my sin, for I know my transgression and my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned and done this evil in your sight, that you might be justified in your sentence and vindicated if you were a judge. For behold, I was conceived in iniquities, and in sins did my mother bear me. For behold, you have loved truth, and hidden in secret things of your wisdom you have revealed to me. Sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be clean, and wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me to hear joy and gladness, my humble bones shall rejoice. Turn your face away from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with your governing spirit, that I will teach transgressors your ways, and your God, they shall turn back to you. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing aloud of your righteousness. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall declare your praise. For if you had desired sacrifice, I would have given it. With whole burnt offerings, you will not be pleased. A sacrifice to God is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Do good, O Lord, to Zion, and good pleasure, and walls of Jerusalem will be felt. Then you will be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and whole burnt offerings. Then they shall offer your bodies and God to you.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, through the prayers of the apostles, O merciful One, Lord of the multitude of our transgressions.
Israel in the depths of the sea. For, O Lord, your holy resurrection, In the beginning, you fashioned me from dust. Working with your pure hands in divine activity, you spread out your hands upon the cross, recalling my corruptible body from the earth, the flesh you took from the Virgin, Lord, Lord, your holy resurrection. The one who planted a soul within me by his divine breath submitted himself to slaughter and surrendered his soul to death. He loosed the everlasting bonds and has raised the dead with himself, glorifying them in incorruption. Lord, Lord, your holy cross and resurrection. Christ is made flesh and makes me divine. Christ is humbled, setting me on high. Christ, the giver of life, enduring the passion in his nature of flesh, has given me freedom from passions. Therefore, I sing to him a song of thanksgiving, for he has been glorified. Monsole Theotokos Sevas. You conceived God, all holy virgin, and by a virgin birth you bore Christ, made flesh of you, the only begotten Son, one person in two natures, for he has been glorified.
All saints of North America, pray God for us. Come, all Orthodox believers, and let us praise in song the saints of our church in America. Let us glorify Christ, who has glorified them. My saints of North America, pray to God for us. Come, let us with one accord sing hymns of praise to all the saints who have shone forth in virtue throughout our land, spiritually nourishing the church of the North, on the North American continent. All you saints of North America, pray to God for us. Come, all we Orthodox believers, let us praise the wonder worker Herman and the holy martyrs Giovanni and Peter and all who labored in the Alaskan vineyard of Christ. These northern lights of the American church are ever shining beacons of piety. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Come, all who love the saints, let us remember our instructors in the faith, the holy bishops Innocent and Deacon, the righteous priest Alexis, for by their teachings they have freed us from the bonds of ignorance, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Accept our songs of thanksgiving, O Virgin full of grace, and deliver us from all tribulation, evil, and distress. For we place our hope in you, for the, as the mighty protectors of the Orthodox Church and the new world.
I will open my mouth, and the Spirit will inspire me. I will offer praise to the Queen and Mother, and celebrating her, I will appear radiant, and rejoicing I will sing of her wonders.
You alone know the weakness of mankind's nature, yet in his passion you took up its form. Gird me with power from on high that I may cry out to you. Holy is the living temple of your pure glory, O lover of mankind. Glory, O Lord, your holy resurrection. O Lord of goodness, you are my God, who in compassion for the fallen have come down to me. By your crucifixion you raised me up, that I may sing to you. Holy is the Lord of glory, his goodness is beyond compare. Glory, O Lord, your holy resurrection. O Christ, the divinely existing life, as compassionate God, you clothed yourself with my corruptible form. You descended into the dust of death, breaking the chains of man's mortality, and on the third day you rose, clothing me with incorruption. Glory, O Lord, your holy cross and resurrection, let us cry out to the one who took the straying sheep upon his shoulders and through the tree took off its sin. You have raised our horn, holy are you, O Lord. Monsole Theotokos Sevas, let us cry out to the Son, made flesh by his own will, without seed from the Virgin, for he kept her as a pure virgin after giving birth. You are God of all. Holy are you, O Lord.
All saints of North America, pray God for us. Rejoice the land of Alaska, for the Orthodox faith has been planted in you, and now bears the fruit of salvation throughout North America. O saints of North America, pray God for us. Let us praise in sacred hymns our Father Herman of Alaska, who has bestowed his blessing upon the world and has left us his holy relics as a source of healing, remaining to honor his memory. All you saints of North America, pray to God for us. Iliamne and Kenai rejoice, and all America is filled with gladness as we trust in the power of your intercessions of holy martyrs Giovanni and Peter. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. We entreat you to intercede for your people, O higher martyr Giovanni and youth Peter, who struggle for the faith, including the shedding of your blood. Teach us to confess with boldness the Orthodox faith and to have no fear of the enemy, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Grant us the help of your prayers, O most holy Lady, for our enemies have overwhelmed us, but through you, O pure one, can we be delivered. Intercede
intercede with your Son that we may be saved.
Shedding of his blood at the hands of the pagans. He was
followed in martyrdom by the Aleut youth, St. Peter, who suffered persecution and martyrdom at the hands of the Roman Catholics rather than renounce the Holy Orthodox faith. St. Innocent, the first bishop of the North American continent and later metropolitan of Moscow in all Russia, arrived in Alaska with his family to serve as a missionary priest. Blessed by God with a multitude of talents and extraordinary zeal, he worked tirelessly among the native peoples of Alaska, establishing and making firm the body of Christ in the new vineyard. Also through the zealous efforts of the great missionary, the righteous priest Jacob, many souls were won for Christ. From Alaska, the faith of the fathers was to spread southward and eastward to California, Canada, and the Midwest, and to the East Coast. The vision of Saint Innocent, that Orthodoxy should flourish in the North American lands, was continued and championed by the Holy Hierarch Tikhon, Archbishop of North America, later Patriarch of Moscow and all Russia, who was to suffer and die under godless communism as a true confessor of the faith. Tikhon was joined both in missionary efforts and in suffering for Christ's sake by the priest martyr John and priest martyr Alexander, who labored in America, later suffered and died in Russia at the hands of the godless. The righteous priest Alexis Toth, himself having returned to the fullness of the Holy Orthodox faith, led thousands of souls from the tragic Union back to the faith of their fathers. Furthermore, the Hierarch Nikolai, Bishop of Zicha, having come to North American shores from his native Serbia, left us many spiritual writings in the tradition of the ascetic fathers. In addition, more have been named among the saints, and we look forward with joyous anticipation when in the fullness of time God will manifest the sanctity of other holy ones, both men and women who are known within his courts as additional fervent intercessors for the new world. Also on this day we sing hymns of praise to the righteous men, women, and children who have glorified God through their lives, filled with faith, hope, and love, and who were in turn glorified by him. We keep festival today, honoring the holy ones who are unknown to us, those who heard the word of God and kept it, and those who we have forgotten and are known only to God. These precious ones worked out their salvation in fear and trembling before God, so that we, following the example of those gone before us, may also live virtuous lives here on this earth, the moments we have left, and attain the heavenly kingdom. Therefore, as we celebrate this holy faith with and this holy feast with gratitude and humility, we cry out with joy, all saints of North America, pray to God for us. Amen.
Beholding you as a mountain overshadowed by the grace of God, the cook with prophetic eyes proclaimed that from you should come the Holy One of Israel for our salvation and restoration. Glory, Lord, your holy resurrection. Who is this Savior that comes forth from Edom? Crowned with thorns, his garment red, he hangs upon the tree. He is the Holy One of Israel, come forth for our salvation and restoration. Glory, Lord, your holy resurrection. Behold, you stand ashamed, disobedient people, for in your majesty is Pilate to hang as an evildoer upon the cross, the one who destroyed the power of death and rose from the tomb as God. Glory, Lord, your holy cross and resurrection. Who is this that comes in beauty from Edom? Christ is revealed to us as the high priest of good things to come. He has put our sins to flight and has opened a new way into the better and more perfect tabernacle with his blood. He is our forerunner into the holy place. Most holy Theotokos, save us. You have repaid Eve's ancient debt, for the new Adam came forth from you. He united himself, a living soul, to reasonable flesh and a pure conception. Christ the Lord in two natures proceeded from you, whom all people rightly magnify.
All you saints of North America, pray to God for us. Along with your monastic brethren, you traveled to Alaska to spread the word of the word. Immediately upon your arrival, Ahar Martyr Juvenali, you zealously began your apostolic mission among the native peoples. All you saints of North America, pray to God for us. Having proclaimed the Orthodox faith to the heathen, you have taken up your abode in the eternal mansions of martyrs Juvenali and Peter. Standing now before the King of Kings, you pray for us who honor your holy memory. All you saints of North America, pray to God for us. O Holy pray that we may heed your wise counsel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. But Father Herman of Alaska, being an intercessor for our land, for you have taught us to confess the Orthodox faith with boldness and without fear of the threats of the adversary, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. The holy mountain of Athos is illumined by your images of Blessed Theotokos, and the cities of America are likewise adorned and sanctified, receiving from you miraculous aid and finding in you a source of consolation. Open to us, O Lady, the doors of care and home.
Divine Jesus, who is seated on the throne of the divinity, came like a gentle cloud into the arms of the pure virgin, and saved those who cry out, glory to your mindful Lord.
You have enlightened the world by the brightness of your coming, O Christ. You illumine the ends of the earth with your cross. Enlighten also with the light of your knowledge the hearts of those who sing hymns to you in true faith. Glory, O Lord, your holy resurrection. The people put the Lord to death on the tree of the cross, the great shepherd of the sheep, but as terrified sheep in Hades, he rescued the dead from the power of death. Glory, O Lord, your holy resurrection. You announced the glad tidings of peace and proclaimed deliverance to the captives by your cross, O my Savior. By your rising, you put the one who held out to shame, showing him to be poor and naked. Glory, O Lord, your holy cross and resurrection. Christ, the existing God, came to the flesh for us. He was crucified, dead, and buried. He rose again and ascended in his own flesh to the Father in light. In the same way, he will come again and save those who rightly serve him. Most holy Theotokos, save us, O most pure and holy Virgin. You brought forth the Holy of Holies, Christ. He is the Redeemer who sanctifies all. As the mother of him who created all, we proclaim you as their baby and queen.
All saints of North America, pray to God for us. Love the holy enlighteners of North America, Innocent, Tikhon, and Raphael, be praised in sacred hymns, along with the Divine Wives, Archpastor Nicholas Zicha, and our father and teacher, Alexis, for they are all sacred vessels of the Spirit. All saints of North America, pray to God for us. Although your sojourn in the New World was short, you accomplished much, for you baptized many in the name of the Triune God. Yet higher martyr Juvenal, your apostolic ministry and your earthly life were cut short by the hands of those whom you sought to lead to Christ's heavenly kingdom. All you saints of North America, pray to God for us. By the weapons of your prayers, and holy martyrs Juvenal and Peter, defend our land and its Orthodox people from all calamity and sorrow. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Shine like a star in heaven, O Holy Father Herman, North Star of Christ Church, and guide us toward the Master and his heavenly kingdom, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Christ has shone forth from the Virgin to enlighten those in darkness and to reconcile God and man.
Oh, the universe marvels at your divine glory, for in your womb, O ever-Virgin, you carry the God of all, and you bore the timeless Son, who gives peace to those who praise you.
The deepest abyss surrounds us, there is no Redeemer. We are counted as sheep. Water. Save your people, O our God, for you are the strength and restoration of the weak. Glory, O Lord, your holy resurrection. We were greatly wounded by the transgression of the first-formed man, O Christ. We have been healed by the stripes which wounded you for our sake, O Lord. For you are the strength and restoration of the weak. Glory, O Lord, your holy resurrection. O Lord Almighty, you have led us up from Hades. You crushed the all-devouring whale by your might, for you are the life, the light, and the resurrection. Glory, O Lord, your holy cross and resurrection. In ancient times, Adam stumbled and fell. He was wounded and deceived in the hope of becoming like God. But he rises, made like God indeed, through union with the Word, through the Passion, gaining freedom from passion. He is glorified as the Son, who sits upon the throne with the Father and the Spirit. Most holy Theotokos, save us, without leaving the bosom of the Father, without beginning, God, who reigns in righteousness, went to dwell and establish himself in the womb of a pure maiden. He who was without a mother became incarnate without a father. His descent without genealogy is awesome and ineffable.
All saints of North America, pray to God for us. We praise your holy heart, innocent, for like the apostles to the Slavs, Cyril and Methodius, you left your homeland to journey to a foreign land. Following their example, you enlightened your new people by translating the Holy Scriptures into their own language. All saints of North America, pray to God for us. O Holy Heart, Tikhon, you provided for the spiritual well-being of the Church in the New World by establishing the monastic tradition. Through your prayers, may the monastery you founded in the mountains of Pennsylvania, named after your heavenly patron, St. Tikhon of Zidane, and all others founded throughout North America following in the ascetic way, be a haven for many who give all in their love of Christ. Holy Heart, all saints of North America, pray to God for us. Holy Hierarchs Raphael and Nicholas, you inspired spiritual renewal in your native land. The Lord led you to the shores of America, where you continued your apostolic ministry, instructing in theology and preaching beauty of the kingdom of God. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. We beseech you, O bishops of Christ, Innocent, Tikhon, Nicholas, Raphael, and John, to dissipate the soul-destroying tempests that assail us. Through your prayers of holy hearts, may we be granted spiritual tranquility, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. As you have continually interceded and before our land at the prayers of the North American saints, look upon us now, most pure Theotokos, and as the hope of the hopeless and the helper of those in distress, grant us a sign of your compassion, O Lady.
O you God-fearing folk, who celebrate this divine and honorable feast of the Mother of God, clap your hands and glorify God, who was born of God.
Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and into ages of ages. Amen. As God, you rose from the tomb in glory, raising the world with yourself. Human nature praises you as God, for death has vanished. Adam exults, O Master. Eve rejoices, for she is free from bondage and cries to you. You are the giver of resurrection to all, O Christ. Let us sing the praises of the Almighty God, who rose on the third day. He shattered the gates of Hades, raising those who had been dead from the ages. He appeared to the myrrh-bearing women in his good pleasure, telling them first to rejoice. He sent them to bring the good news to the apostles. They announced the signs of victory to the disciples. Hades groaned, death lamented, while the world and all people rejoiced together. For you are the giver of resurrection to all, O Christ. We the faithful behold you as the spiritual furnace of Theotokos, for as the Most High saved the three children, so he renewed my entire nature in your womb. The most praised and glorified God of our fathers, Lord, Lord, your holy resurrection. The earth trembled with fear, the sun turned back, and the light was darkened. The sacred veil of the temple was torn in two, and the rocks were split. For the righteous God hung upon the cross, the most praised and glorified God of our fathers. Glory to the Lord, your holy resurrection. Of your own will, for our sake, you became as one helpless and wounded among the dead. You set us free by your mighty arm, raising us up with yourself, O most praised and glorified God of our fathers. Glory to the Lord, your holy cross and resurrection. The earth of old was cursed, died with the blood of Abel from his murdering brother's hand. Now it is blessed, sprinkled with the divine stream of your blood, and leaping for joy it cries, blessed are you, O God of our fathers. Most holy Theotokos, save us. Behold, the angel, like lightning, cried to the myrrh-bearing women, come and see the shroud and the tomb. Look at the signs of the resurrection of Christ and cry, blessed are you, O God of our fathers.
All saints of North America, pray to God for us. Knowing that the Lord guides our man safely in the way that he should go, you left your comfortable life in Irkutsk, the Holy Heart, Innocent, to live a rigorous one in Alaska among the Aleuts, and in order to spread the gospel of Christ. All saints of North America, pray to God for us. Though your years were few in number, O Holy Martyr Peter, your wisdom was great, for you wisely chose to endure the tortures of the ungodly men who insisted you renounce your faith. Intercede with Christ our God, that we too may endure all assaults against us. All saints of North America, pray to God for us. Abhorring the exploitation of the Alaskan lands and its people, you sought to protect them, for you had made them your own, O Holy Father Herman. You unceasingly intercede before God and the civil authorities on their behalf. Now, as then, intercede before the Lord on behalf of us all. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Having you as our sure anchor of hope and immovable rampart, O Holy Father Herman of Alaska, we are delivered from the hostile assaults of the enemy by your powerful intercession before the throne of God, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. By your all honorable icon and Sitka, we have received as a divine gift from on high Theotokos, which we have received as a divine gift from on high Theotokos. May we ever increase in love for your Son and our God, and be delivered from every hostile assault of the enemy.
The God fearing did not serve creatures, but only the Creator of all, and manfully trampling on the menacing fire, they rejoice in him, most glorious Lord, God of our fathers, blessed are you.
The Israelite children shone in the furnace with the beauty of godliness brighter than melting gold, and they cried, "Bless the Lord, all works of the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all ages. Glory, O Lord, your holy resurrection, a word of God, of your own will, you create and fashion all things new. By your passion, you have transformed the shadow of death into life eternal. All works of the Lord, bless the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all ages. Glory, O Lord, your holy resurrection, you arose on the third day of Christ from the tomb, destroying the chaos and misery within the gates and bars of Hades. All works of the Lord, bless the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all ages. Glory, O Lord, to your holy cross and resurrection. Come, O people, let us worship the place where the pure feet of Christ stood, the tree where his divine and life-giving hands were stretched out for the salvation of the human race. At the life-bearing tomb, let us sing, let the whole creation bless the Lord and exalt him above all forever. Most holy Theotokos, save us. O all praise Virgin, the cause of our salvation, as you have borne the Lord, pray for all who unceasingly cry, that the whole creation bless the Lord and exalt him above all forever.
All saints of North America, pray God for us. Through your prayers to the all-merciful Lord, Holy Hierarchs, Innocent, Tikhon, Nicholas, Raphael, and John, may we be delivered from the tempestuous passions that assail us, and may we always cry, bless the Lord, our works of the Lord. All you saints of North America, pray to God for us. As archpastor of your North American flock, you led the procession to the site where the monastery dedicated to the memory of your heavenly patron now stands. O Holy Hierarch Tikhon, we the faithful give thanks to you and joyfully accept this gift to us as we cry, bless the Lord, our works of the Lord. All saints of North America, pray to God for us. Just as the three youths chose to defy the tyrant, you, O Holy Martyr Peter, chose physical death over the spiritual death of apostasy. Pray that we may give ourselves fully to the Lord as we cry, bless the Lord, our works of the Lord. Let us bless the Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. O Holy Father Herman, glory of Alaska, and all America, cease not to pray for us. We cry, bless the Lord, our works of the Lord, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Just as the three youths were not consumed by the flames, you were not consumed by the divine fire which dwelt in your virginal womb. Therefore, Theotokos, we exalt you throughout all ages. We praise, bless, and worship the Lord, singing and exalting him above all forever.
The noble young men in the furnace of Babylon were saved by the birth-giving of the Virgin, for then it was prefigured, and now it is in fact. Therefore, all the young men intercede, praise the Lord, all you servants of the exalt and glorify him forever.
was the type of your pure childbearing, O Theotokos. Now quench for us the raging furnace of temptations, we pray, that we may unceasingly magnify you. Glory, O Lord, your holy resurrection. Behold how the lawless and disobedient people justify the accursed and godless man. They condemn the righteous one, the Lord of glory, to the tree, him whom we rightly magnify. Glory, O Lord, your holy resurrection. We glorify you, O Savior, the innocent Lamb, who takes away the sins of the world, risen on the third day. Together with the Father and your divine Spirit, we acknowledge you as God and magnify you, the Lord of glory. Glory, O Lord, your holy cross and resurrection. Your cross, O Lord, is glorified by your ineffable strength. For your weakness is revealed as stronger than all power. Through it, the mighty are cast down to the earth, and the poor are brought in safety back to heaven. Holy Trinity, our God, glory be to thee. The nature without beginning or end is known in three single divine persons, one Godhead, in the Father, the Son, and the Spirit, in whom Orthodox Christians put their trust and are saved. And so, Holy Theotokos, save us. Every rule of praise is brought low by the greatness of your glory, O most pure Virgin. Yet, O Lady, accept a song of praise, for it is offered to you in love by your unworthy servants. Receive your aid.
All saints of North America, pray to God for us. Rejoice, O saints of the New World, both revealed and hidden, known and unrecognized, who have been glorified by the Lord. Entreat him to grant us consolation and sorrow, to confirm our land and piety and our people in the Orthodox faith, and to accept as our humble gift this hymn of praise and thanksgiving. All saints of North America, pray to God for us. Rejoice, O saints of the New World, for on this, the holy feast, for us flowers you've adorned the true vine, which has budded forth in our land. All saints of North America, pray to God for us. Rejoice, O saints of the New World, all you who have reached the heavenly kingdom and now stand before the throne of the King of Glory, intercede with our merciful God to grant unity to the Church, so that with one mind and voice we may unceasingly witness to the truth and praise the consubstantial Trinity. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Most Holy Trinity, accept our gift, the American Church, which has been offered to you as choice incense. Through the prayer of those who have served and pleased you, confirm this land in peace, and preserve our people from all assaults of the enemy, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. We on earth, together with the heavenly hosts, magnify your Son and our God, Theotokos, and we glorify you as the protector of the Church. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
and moon, praise Him, all your stars and light, praise Him, your heaven of heavens and your waters above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for He spoke and they came to be. He commanded and they were created. He established them forever, yea, forever and ever. He has made a decree which will not pass away. Praise the Lord from the earth, you dragons and all deeps, fire, hail, snow, and frost. Stormy wind fulfilling His word, mountains and all hills, fruitful trees and all cedars, beasts and all cattle, creeping things and feathered birds, kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and all judges of the earth, young men and maidens, old men and children. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for His name alone is exalted. His glory is on earth and in heaven, and He has exalted the horn of His people. All His saints will praise Him, even the children of Israel, the people near to Him. Sing to the Lord a new song, His praise in the congregation of the saints. Let Israel rejoice in Him that made Him. Let the sons of Zion rejoice in their King. Let them praise His name with the dance. Let them sing praises to Him with timbrel and harp. For the Lord takes pleasure in His people. He will exalt the meek and save them. Let the saints be exalted in glory. They will rejoice in their beds. The praises of God shall be in their mouths and two-edged swords in their hands, to execute vengeance on the nations and chastisement on the people, to bind their kings with fetters and their nobles with chains of iron, to execute on them the judgment that is written, such as the glory of all His saints.
We live in your saving passion, O Christ, and glorify your resurrection.
Praise God and His saints, praise Him in the firmament of His power.
Make us worthy of
again teach those who were untaught, and pray that our souls may be saved.
Thy steps are ordered by the Lord, he establishes those in whose way he delights.
Shall we worthily give thanks to you, O saints of North America, who illumined us with the light of Christ, who led us from darkness and shadow, guiding us for the uncreated light, along the way nourishing us with the food of the kingdom. So today we are been invited, gather and celebrate your sacred memories, and we pray that our souls may be saved.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
The women who were with Mary preparing sweet spices, and wondering how they might be accomplishing their goal, they saw that the stone had been rolled away. A young man sent from God calmed all the anxiety of their souls, for he said, "The Lord Jesus is risen." Proclaim then to his disciples and the preachers that they should hasten to Galilee and behold him risen from the dead, for he is the Lord and giver of life.
Amen.
Christ, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Every day we'll
of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. In the name of the Lord, I give the blessing.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save all us.
Amen.
The last time we sang tone one for the praises, and Lord, I call was Holy Saturday morning and Holy Saturday night. 8 weeks ago. Bless me, holy mothers and sisters, and forgive the sins that I, a sinner, have committed this day, in deed, word, and thought, and through all my senses.
May God forgive you and have mercy on you, holy mother. Bless me, holy mother, and forgive all the sins I've committed this day, in deed, word, and thought, and through all my senses, and pray for me, a sinner.
May God in his grace